concert of the sixth grade band. We are starting off the concert with a classic patriotic theme. Well, it isn't the national anthem, it's very well known and loved as a reminder of some of the images that make this country the wonderful place it is. The lyrics were originally published as a poem in 1875 by English professor Catherine Lee Bates, and the tunes which we will play was penned by Samuel Ward. This is a program piece for band. We will be playing four different movements which will help illustrate the Southern Australian Aboriginal tale of the origin of the world. The narration of the movements 1 to 4 will be read before we start the performance, and the last narration will relate to the end of the tale. Please hold your applause until the last narration after the fourth movement.
Movement 1 and 2, telling the story of the plight of the first humans and the superhuman being Bella the Sun Warrior. She would use her firelight to draw the humans to her, and then she would eat them. Movement 3, Kundu, or Kudnu, depending on the source, is a lizard man who is known for his 5 hunting boomerangs. His skill was legendary. He became angry when he went to visit his human friends and they had all been eaten by Bella.
Movement 4. Kundu carefully approached the sun woman, who was relaxing by the fire. Bella saw him and, smiling with hate, hurled fireballs at him. Kundu moved closer and closer to the campfire, seeking shelter from the fireballs. Bella reached for her spear. Kundu saw his chance and threw a boomerang with all his might at the warrior. He struck Bella with great force and she fell backward into her fire. Together, they became a deafening fireball that rolled off the edge of the earth.
All right, I'm just gonna interject for just a minute. We are going to, after these 4 movements, we're going to have a short reading by 3 of our other students that's going to finish the performance. There's supposed to be a 5th movement, but due to some scheduling things, I was not able to get the 5th movement in front of the kids in time, which is completely on me. But we are not gonna play you the 5th movement, but we're gonna read you what the 5th movement is going to be depicting after we finish the first 4 movements. So after we have that final reading, we'd love for you to respond with your applause at that point. Thank you.
Thank you.
Immediately, the whole place was plunged into darkness. Kundu stood there in darkness and silence. He'd saved his people from the Sun Woman, but at what cost? Now there was no light. He stood there horrified at what he had done, not knowing how to bring the light back again. Then Kundu remembered he still had 4 boomerangs left.
So he turned to the north, took a boomerang, and threw it. He rayed it. Nothing happened. The darkness remained. He turned to the south and threw another boomerang. He waited, but again, nothing happened. Kundu turned to the west and threw a 3rd boomerang, but nothing happened, not even a glimmer of light.
Finally, he slowly turned to the east. He took his last remaining boomerang and raised it back far past his head. And with all of his strength, he threw it. In the darkness and deep silence, the warrior waited and waited until finally an amazing thing began to happen. A light appeared in the eastern sky.
Between Bella and America. The bold Western themes are inspired by the 1800s cowboys and recall the time when indigenous people interacted with the people who were new to their land. Both America's and Australia's stories need to be remembered so we can learn from their mistakes and inform the future.
Thank you.
a retired Fairport teacher. He wrote the song to feature the low brass and woodwind instruments, who are the foundation of any good band. These kids often play a role that is very different to the bold feature they have in this song.
Things that I want to point out and say and people that think and things like that before I turn it over to Val for our last introduction. I did want to introduce the people who spoke to you. We heard from Avery Seckel, Anya Rohr, Nathan Wagner, Jaden Zayden, I'm trying to read my handwriting here, Caroline Como. Let's see here. Now that I'm a singleton, and we're going to hear from Val Kandertenko. And then our last three readings in Bella were from Lisa Magnion, Isabel Alexander, and Will Pecor. So I want to thank all of them for stepping out into the limelight. A lot of people wanted to, and not everybody gets a chance, so I try to spread it around. I did want to thank Dave Luce and our custodial staff because they're absolutely phenomenal. They make it so that we can get all this stuff done, so I just can't thank them enough. Our administrators, who we have a couple of here tonight, so thank you, because they're awesome as well. And as always, the two people that I need to thank the most for the help around here are Sarah Fisher, Dr. Fisher, and Kendra Land, because without them, this just absolutely would not happen the way it does. We're really lucky to to have this team that we do have. And I also want to thank my family for all the time that they give up. My son was helping me mark parts over the weekend and things like that. And so my family's awesome, and I want to thank them once more. And I need to especially thank one person, because every single band rehearsal, she asks me if there's anything she can do at the end of rehearsal. She stays after with me, and she asks for permission to leave at the end of the day, because she wants to make sure that I don't need anything before she can leave. So Jade, thank you very much for all of your help during the year. So I am going to turn the microphone over to Val, but I did want to just remind you one more time about that ice cream social. I think the temperature in here should be reminder enough.
The Russian modest Mussorgsky was inspired by his friend Victor Hartmann's art to compose this work. Some of the art is lost, but the piano work has been turned into several orchestra and band arrangements. The Pranodon theme changes into the creepy, ominous hut of Baba Yaga, a witch. The last theme is inspired by the competition to design a gate for the capital city of Ukraine, Kyiv. The gate wasn't built, but this fantastic work could be its legacy. Thank you, parents, for your support and love, and have a great summer.
celebrating summer.